Rob here. We're in Cherokee, Alabama at the Coon Dog Cemetery. We talked about we're going to go to some interesting places, and this is one of them that I've always wanted to go to. We raised coon dogs when I was younger, and the last two we had, Rowdy and Susie, black and tan coon dogs that I can remember falling around at night up and down the mountain with my rifle in my hand and just listen to them sing. And so this is a place started in 1937 dedicated to burying coon dogs, and it has to be a coon dog. Can't run deer, not supposed to treat possums, has to be a verified hound. So we're here, and I'm going to read the eulogy that when they bury a coon dog by William Ramsey, and then we'll just pan through the cemetery. Till Smokey Rob, till next time, stay smoky. Let not your hearts be troubled, for in his master swamp there are many den trees. If it is not so, I would have told you. He has gone to prepare a place for you, and where he has gone, Old Red will go also. Dogs, they say, do not have souls. They only have hide and bones. But I believe there is a coon dog heaven, and Red has gone where the good coon dogs go. Anyone that coon hunts has to believe in God. If you have known the music of coon hounds on a trail, and heard the excitement in their voices when they strike, and have seen the eagerness and determination when they tree, if you have seen their courage and bravery in a tough fight with an old boar coon, if you have heard their anguished cries and howls, if you have seen the ugly gashes and bleeding wounds, and have witnessed their resolve to never quit, you know there has to be a God to make such an animal like that, and a God that would make a coon dog won't forget him when he is gone. There's a coon dog heaven, and Old Red is there, and every night he runs, and the den trees are there in the old swamp, and the old hunter's moon hangs low in the west, and the coons don't go up no slick bark trees, and the carbide don't run out. There ain't no bull nettles and saw briars, and old master always knocks the coon out and lets Old Red grab him and give him a good shake. And then he gets the pat on the head and climbs back into the kennel in the back of the pickup truck and goes home and sleeps all day. 'Cause he knows in coon dog heaven, he can hunt again. When the sun goes down and the tree frogs holler, may the bones of Old Red rest in peace. Through the mercy of God, may the coon hunter's light perpetually shine upon him. Amen.